nice to see you.
Well, we have your room all ready. It is not like before the war, but we shall make you as comfortable as we can.
Oh, it's comfortable just to look at your faces again.
I tried to persuade her to come and stay with me, but she said the Knupels would never forgive her.
Oh, her we would forgive. It is you who would not forgive.
Doctor.
Oh, Monsieur and Madame DeLambre, Fräulein Alten.
Welcome to our ivory tower, mademoiselle.
Thank you.
You must be staffed. Come, we have geschnetzelt this evening.
Oh, what a lieber Mann. She would want to go to her room first.
Oh, yes. Oh, I always forget
these. Well, I must be off. I shall see you tomorrow afternoon for tea.
Yes, of course. Thank you for meeting me.
I, too, shall see you tomorrow, Fräulein.
Oh, Andreas. It's all right? Is everything arranged?
Tomorrow, after you are all settled, I'll give you a full report.
No, Andreas. After dinner.
All right, I'll see you after dinner.
What have you been doing since the war, Fräulein?
Oh, struggling, working. Trying to get enough money to come back here. Mm-hmm. Who are all these people? Mm-hmm. Who's that man I met?
Oh, Monsieur DeLambre, a wealthy intellectual, a writer, he says, and a mountain climber.
He says.
Those are just tourists.
And the American?
He doesn't talk much about himself. His name is Ordway. He was a bomber pilot. During the war, he was shot down near here. And he came back.
He plays the harmonica.
Mm-hmm. Does he climb, too?
Yes, occasionally. He's very good, really. But I do not think he's serious about it. Oh, the other one, Hein, he's really a climber.
Why is he here?
I think for the same reason that you are here.
Andres has told you.
Do you think anyone had to tell us that someday you would come back to the White Tower?